Hi there. You have seen how to use the substitution method to evaluate indefinite integrals, that is, integrals without boundaries. In this video, I will show you how to use substitution in the case of a definite integral, an integral with boundaries. Let's consider an explicit example, the integral of 2x times e to the power 3 plus x squared, where x ranges from 1 to 2. Of course, we can always do the following. First, calculate the indefinite integral to find an antiderivative. We can use the substitution u equal to 3 plus x squared. Then du equals 2x dx. We can rewrite the indefinite integral as the integral of e to the power u du. This is equal to e to the power u plus c. In terms of x, we get e to the power 3 plus x squared plus c. We can use this antiderivative to evaluate our original integral. Plug the upper boundary and the lower boundary into the antiderivative and subtract. We get e to the power 7 minus e to the power 4. Now you may think, that is a lot of work, and you would be right. There is a faster method. We can use substitution directly in the integral with boundaries. First, we rewrite the integral as we are used to do. The only new thing we have to think of is what to do with the boundaries. Well, in the original integral, the boundaries indicate the smallest and largest value of the variable x. X ranges from 1 to 2. In the new integral, we should put the corresponding boundaries for the variable u. If x is equal to 1, then u is equal to 4. If x is equal to 2, then u is equal to 7. So the new integral becomes e to the power u du, with u ranging from 4 to 7. This we can easily calculate. A primitive function is e to the power u. Now plug in the boundaries and subtract. We get e to the power 7 minus e to the power 4. The same answer as before. There's no need to return to the original variable x. The value of the new integral is just the same as the value of the old one. There's one more thing that you should be aware of. After a substitution, the boundaries may be in the wrong order. For example, consider the integral from 0 to pi of cosine of x squared times sine of x dx. We can substitute u equal to cosine of x. Then du is equal to minus sine of x dx, which we can rewrite to sine of x dx equal to minus du. We can re-express the integral as integral of minus u squared du. What will the boundaries be? Well, if x is equal to 0, u is equal to the cosine of 0, which is 1. So the new lower boundary is 1. If x is equal to pi, then u is equal to the cosine of pi, that is, minus 1. So the new upper boundary is minus 1. You see that the boundaries are in the wrong order. But this is easily resolved. As we have seen in previous videos, we can swap the boundaries, but we have to add a minus sign. Thus, the integral becomes minus the integral of minus 1 to 1 of the function minus u squared du. That are a lot of minus signs. However, two minus signs cancel, and we get the integral of minus 1 to 1 of u squared du. This is easily evaluated. A primitive function is 1 over 3 u cubed, and in the end, we get 2 over 3 as a result. To summarize, you can use substitution also in case of integrals with boundaries. Just make sure to re-express these boundaries in terms of the new variable. In case the boundaries end up in the wrong order, simply swap them and add a minus sign. You can practice this in the exercises.